Yeah, the demo doesn't even feel like Final Fantasy. It feels like future fantasy. That's what 15 feels like. I liked 13. I have not actually finished the 13 series personally. Again, you know, I've got access to 13, 13.2, and 13.3 all on the PlayStation 3, and I do want to stream them all at some good some point. Probably take me 1 month to get all through them games, and I will bust my butt doing so. However, completionist will not happen on 13, 13.2, and 13.3. because those games will take absolutely forever. Yeah, it feels like an action game, not an RPG. Yeah, I know what you mean, but dang. 15 is definitely that way. I mean, they're driving cars around. Yeah, I have all three. I've not even played 13.3. I know she's back. And you're playing around with time in some aspect, but I don't know what all is going on in it, period. Like, I want everything to be new to me, unless I need help, and then I also have the booklet as well. Alright, get those job class levels, my friends. Get those job class levels. Heck yeah. Should be 5 more matches. Uh-oh, the keyword raffles in 30 seconds. It closes. Closes in 30. Yeah, I know, right? Only 2 entries. What? Xanth, say something in chat, my friend. Say something in chat. Congratulations. Woo! Yeah! We hit okay there. Should I gamble them to the bot? That's up to you, man. It's up to you. We do have another World of Warships key going out. Somewhere. No, we were at like the last 6 episodes. Yeah. basically episode 18, like somewhere 16, 17, somewhere in there. I'll end up watching it all over again at some point. Because I don't really remember the story. You know? Go. We'll kill him on the next run. Yeah! Alright, gaining them job levels. Heck yeah! Just a couple more levels, guys. Just a couple more. Monk is in Final Fantasy III. Apparently I'm playing it, you said, as the black belt. And it has Retaliate, the counter. Really? But the guide says black belt is just better. Really? Okay. Black belt is just better? Yeah, but what about a ninja over the black belt? I was curious about that. Ninja over the black belt. Monk was one of the first classes you get. Well, I have all the classes. Because I was looking at endgame builds and I was going to go Devout for our White Mage. And then I was going to go Knight Dragoon. And then, you know, I had another class in mind. I can't think of it. It's either Ninja or Black Belt. I can't really remember. Killing him after this round of guarding and studying? Hmm. Yeah! Oh, three more matches, guys. Three more. Not four, three more. Bum, 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 bum. Black belt. Ninja is kind of squishy and says you need to buy a bunch of shurikens to do high damage. Yeah, I could do that. That's not a big deal. I take it shurikens are used in battle based on the ninja. That's fine. J-Dogs are black belt then. That's fine. That is just fine. And we already have Weirdo as our Dragoon. I'm going to make Arcade our Devout. And frickin' Heaven will be our Knight. Yeah, you throw away the shurikens, you throw them. Yep, that's what I figured. What's this one, Dave? Oh. Boost. One more round of guarding. Wow, that crit. She got them glasses. Crazy. Yeah, Arcade gains a level. Two more matches, guys. Two more. And then we can go get the special weapon for the White Mage or whatever it happens to be. Let's see, it'll be the Angel Robe with 45 defense and 20 to mind. Because that's what I've been looking at, is the defensive gear. Like, the offensive gear would be badass, sweet. However, we do need that defensive gear for endgame. And that's why I've been grinding out these classes. Like, let's see. Right now, I've got the White Mage. He's going to get the Angel Robe. 45 defense plus 20 to mind is the special. Its crystal is Earth. Correction. Wind. Sorry. The Black Belt gets Master Dogi, which is 54 defense. You get nice stat bonuses at class level 99, too. I know. So should I, like, play as an Onion Knight? Is an Onion Knight even a feasible character for endgame? That's what I want to know. Because he does get to use, like, everything. And, like, base white and black magic. Not summons, but white and black magic. So that's where I question, like, should I have an Onion Knight instead of a regular knight? Right. Oh, really? Wait, who's 98? Weirdo is about to be ready to go. Weirdo has one more level to gain. Has a level 99 summoner. Summoner gets astral bracers. 47 defense, plus 10 mind, and plus 10 intellect. That's freaking sweet for some bracers. Xanth, is there anything, what did the Onion Knights get as stat bonuses? Because I feel like they're extremely low for those guys. It says Onion Knight is the ultimate character. Yeah, I've got two of them pretty much like I've got one at 99 and the other one's about to be level 89 or 99. Plus 7 to all stats. That's weak. That's so weak. Is that you? Oh, okay. Okay, I heard it, but I didn't know where it came from. Sure.
Okay.
Yep. Aw, damn it. Weirdo didn't gain a level. Damn! Let's see, they have the highest base attack in the game? Really? So do you think having two of them would be better than having a black belt and a knight? Do you think I'm better off having two onion knights, a dragoon, and then a devout? Yes, Weirdo gained a level. Sweet. Owned at 99, they have 99 strength, 99 agility, 99 vitality, 99 intel, and 99 mind. That's not what showed up on my end. We need to go find her. We have a level 99 summoner right now. It's best to do because these two places are so close. What smells burnt? Darn it. That blacksmith. That might be character level 99. Ah, got you. Got it. Yeah, I am working on those levels as well. Because the Crystal Tower is the best place for me to level currently at level 60 through 99. I see you have a Master Summoner among you. Here, you should have this insignia. Obtain Summoner card. In addition, I will give you this to you in praise of your achievements. Obtained Astral Bracers. I will now continue my travels. Nice! Oh wait, it was the summoner, that's right. Look at that, wow! Thank you, babe. You don't want any?
That's the last one.
Here, take half.
No! I can't.
Yeah, you can.
No, I can't.
Mm-hmm.
No.
You put it down.
It's stuck anyway, so shut up.
Job. See, we already have a dragoon. Get him to be a warrior. Let's see, Weirdo, equip. All right. Okay, 10 matches away. 10 matches away. Bam! We've been doing so much work that this is insane, guys. Insane, if you ask me. What up, Viper? How you doing? I'm all alone here. Like, I'm the only voice for the channel. How are you and your friend doing? Yeah, Mac stats is pretty damn sexy. Hell yeah. Like, I want some Mac stats. Because, my characters are gonna need it. Well, okay then. Viper, what are you up to? What are you doing? And you know, Game Key 5 and 6 are on PlayStation Network. You could get those to own them, then emulate. I could. I very much could so. I'll save that for when I get the Elgato this fall. I don't have the money to actually get 5 and 6 on the PlayStation Network. I hear you. Alright, Dan. Guys, also, my PlayStation code, if you guys want to actually be my friends on PlayStation, it's GameKey88. GAMEKEY88. That's my PlayStation. So. Throwing it at me.
I know you're talking about.
Oh,
yeah? That wasn't me.
You're the only one.
Not down here. It's nobody else. I do, and I'm up here on my tablet. That is my excuse, because it wasn't me.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't me. I didn't do it. It wasn't me.
Someone had still taken my name. Well, arcade's about to level up. There we go. Be right back. My cats think they need food or some such silliness. Okay. Not a problem, Xanth. Black Mage 1, what's up, dude? How are you? How are you doing, man? We did just level up a Black Mage to level 99 in the job class. We've been job classing like crazy today. We've already gotten like 6 job classes maxed out. This is an awesome day. Alright, so let's do this, guys. Bam! The last of the World of Warship keys, my friends. The last. So, exclamation ticket, space, and the number of GC you want to use up to 2,000. So, exclamation ticket, 1 through 2,000 to enter, my friends. PJ's acquired, cats fed, bachelor job level increases. That's funny. Xanth's bachelor level increases. So how's it going, Xanth? You can call me on Skype if you want, man. It's just me chilling and having a good time with you guys. Who was it that's about to hit? Arcade, 7 more. I'm doing quests in 14, so that has a lot of my attention. Ah, gotcha. Gotcha, Xanth. Not a big deal. Not a big deal. Oh, snap. Look at this. 7 more matches, and we will have our level 99 White Mage job class through Arcade. A White Mage there. Nice. All right, look at that. Hey Xanth, are you excited about the new DLC for Final Fantasy 14? Considering you get to go to space and job classes and all that craziness? Them books apparently make people smart. Look at all that damage. Yeah, everyone's gaining job levels. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Expansion? No. Space, just a new region and new classes. Well, are you excited about it anyway? What are the new classes, by the way? I mean, share with us in chat. Let us know what the new classes are and how they are different from the rest. And what is this new region you speak of? doing story quests in the new area right now. Is it nice? Like, do you like it? Astrologist, Machinist, and Dark Knight. Get that stretch on. The story is amazing. Nice, nice. Astrologist is a new healer class that can give random buffs. That's kind of cool. Not sure about the Machinist. Dark Knight is oddly a tank class. Interesting. Five more battles, and we have ourselves a white mage at level 99. Again, you heard me, a white mage at level 99. That's freaking OP. Yep, zero viewers entered. That means GC raffles the rest of the night. And that's if people actually are here. There we go. Ha! You guys enter for the GC, but not the game. You guys make me laugh. That's great. Already got it. Thank you. No point in me. So many of you have the games have the game already, so it's like, yeah, no point. I'm still excited for that other MMO. Okay. I can always use more GC. My cat pulled my power cord from my power strip out of the wall. Oh my god. Dude. Oh my goodness. What up, Black Mage? How you doing, man? Nice. How you been, Black Mage? I'm not doing too bad, just waiting on the desktop to get fixed again. Like, guys, I've already sent this desktop in to get fixed, and they also sent me graphics cards last fall. Like, 1 month right after the other. And then I also sent the desktop back out. Which reminds me, I do have to check a page. Whoa. Yeah, I'm doing really good. I just really want my desktop fixed, but I will be building my own desktop piece by piece starting this fall. I will be buying a Phantom case, like the ridiculous full tower case with all those fans in it, because yes, I want it. Like, it's a big deal to me. You guys just don't understand, like, I want to give you the best quality stream that I can, and this is gonna be the only way I do it, is giving you the best as much as I can. As much as I'd love to have two GTX 980 Ti's, you know, I'm only gonna be able to have one, because I'm spending less than what I paid for the one from iBuyPower. But it's still a lot of money. I'm probably going to pull like $600 this fall on just the case and the motherboard and the CPU. I'm probably going to drop like $800 or $900. But I have to make that money back over the winter break. You know, and I'll keep everything in their boxes until I get the desktop back and start testing parts and all that craziness, which is going to be awesome. It is going to be nice, though. It's going to be a Phantom. I'm going to have a MX, I think it's a X99X ASRock motherboard. So it's going to support Wi-Fi and all that good stuff. It's insane. And then I'm looking at the next i7 CPU above the 4790. However, if the prices drop this fall, I want to get the 5800, the 8-core CPU. It runs at lower gigahertz, but it's powerful. I'm also looking at getting a 1200 power supply, 1200 gold watt Corsair power supply. This would be gold certified through Newegg. I'm getting most, if not everything, from Newegg. The Iron Egg guarantee, is that a lifetime? Yeah, I want to get the new i7. But it's like $1,000. Like, if I just bought the i7, that's $1,000. That's no case, no motherboard. I'm just dropping $1,000 on just a CPU chip. And I can't... I want to have my case first. Three more levels, guys. All in Diz. What up, my friend? How are you? Welcome to the channel. But yeah, I'll be custom building this one part by part, and I will make sure they have warranties. Not that I don't trust them, but iBuyPower has kind of let me down that parts will fail all the time. Like, I'm expecting everything to fail no matter what all the time. Like, I don't even know how I'm streaming right now on my laptop. that's how somewhat... That's how I feel a little bit. If you need a large PC case, that's good. Go with the Cooler Master HAX Full Tower case. Well, I was going to go with that big Phantom case. It's got like 7 fans in it already that come with it, and I also have extra fans to put in it as well. And that's what has me a little bit of excited. It has all of these extra fans, and I am excited to be playing with a full tower. Not to mention, you said a Cooler Master. Is that some of the coolest, temperature cases? They keep the PC the coolest? I mean, besides water cooled? Hey, Bear Rippers, just send me a Twitch message with the name of it. No, the newest i7 that's out there is $1,068, roughly. It's over the four-figure marker. Darn it. Still, 3 more matches. Everyone else is doing good and leveling up. Alright, thank you. Yep. Hold on, I know. Wow, nice. That's That's ridiculous. That is outrageously huge. Okay. Is that a SATA cable port on the front of it? Jeez. Wow, look at that power supply partition. That's awesome. That is freaking sick. I mean, it looks like a monster. It really looks like it's for extended ATX boards, so it fits everything. Nice. Sorry if that was loud. Normal ATX, and it has 9 PCI ports. Yeah. Yeah, 9 PCI ports. Oh my god. Could you imagine filling up all of those? That's ridiculous. It's cold and runs quiet. How hot is your place? Like, because my apartment runs like 80 degrees year round, except for the winter. I need to know if it stays cool. That's what I'm really looking at. I know it's not a big cooling issue on my end. That's causing all these problems. The fact that it's not being built correctly, and that I'm having software issues all the time is my concern. Like, I feel like the R9-290 I have in that desktop is like not meshing with the motherboard. And other problems are persisting, and like, it just makes me a little upset. You know, because it's been 10 months. It's been 10 frickin' months. And here I am, like, spending my summer playing on a laptop when I should be streaming from a desktop, doing 24-hour streams, playing Ark, playing Dirty Bomb. You know, I should be playing these new games with you guys and having a good time. But, you know, iBuyPower is looking into what's really going wrong. And the fact that they paid for the service this time is a big deal because, yeah, I'm still having issues. And I'm going to laugh if it's considered a heat issue, because what I get on the programs is like, oh, my graphics card runs at like 60 Celsius, and my CPU maxes out at 81. And that I can't push them any further, and yet they're going to tell me somehow I managed to push that even further and, you know, break something. Like, it's impossible. Especially, like, streaming the way I do. Like, I've already had tests put my computer under even more rigorous tests than streaming. And I don't know. So, what do you guys, like, what do you guys think? I mean, some people are telling me I shouldn't even spend over $1,000 on a streaming PC. Like, do you think that's true? Because I see my biggest expenses being a graphics card, a CPU, and a power supply unit. And then I have to keep all of that stuff running cool to maintain the stream. Two more matches. I can't say anything. My video card was $700 when I bought it. Yeah, I know. But it's like, how do you justify for a streaming PC? How do you justify that? This is how you justify it. You gotta spend money to make money. Yeah, but I mean, like, I get that, but like, what I mean is, how can I say a $1,000 CPU is worth it versus like a $2,000? Who's just screaming? Oh. I don't know. I bought mine for me. It can stream. So cool. Sweet. That's freaking awesome. Like, that's what I mean. It's like, I want to say, yes, this is the reason why I'm buying it, but I also want it to be able to work. This is like, with my experience with iBuyPower so far, I'm worried. I'm worried that none of my parts are going to work whenever I get them. You know, that's what makes me, you know, hesitant now. And I'm gonna go for it regardless, but it's still a big worry for me. Oh, it's about stats and what you want out of it. Different chips are better for gaming, some are better for graphics processors, etc. Alright. Which chip is currently best for gaming? Is it the new i7s? The newest of i7s? The 8 cores? Because I was rocking the 4790, and it's crazy. I did everything for 3 months and, like, was rocking it. And then our computer went down. Yeah, PC from them should be more than adequate for streaming. Yeah, I hope so. It really is overkill. And when I buy another PC, when I start piecing, parting this one together, my newer one, my iBuy Power PC will become my streaming PC. I'll be doing a dual stream PC setup. So that way I can run at 1080p, 60 frames per second, and still give you guys the highest graphics gameplay possible. Like, that's what I'm excited about. I am super excited. But a major thing I've seen so far to focus on is the higher the cores and the faster it runs with the lowest temperatures and power draws. That's the same for the RAM and GPU also. Quad core with hyper-threading is good enough for gaming. 8 is ridiculous. I know. 8's ridiculous. And that's what the new i7 is. That's what the newest i7 is. It's 8 and it's like set for hyper-threading. And that's just like, that's perfect to be streaming Evolve on a good, like, badass stream, like, perfect. And I'm cool with that, because some of these guys are running, like, older parts, but they're running at, like, 30 frames at, like, 720p. I want to be that guy who comes out, like, swinging, you know, 60 frames per second, 1080p graphics, the best graphics possible. And I want to be like, hey guys, guess what? I'm ridiculous and I'm a new streamer. Like, that's what I've been trying to go for. You know, and like playing Ark, oh my god. Yeah, the video card matters so much more. I believe it. And the thing is when I sat down and played Ark, I lost track of time. I was ready to sit down and continue playing Ark. And then the desktop went down. And that scares the crap out of me. Because I lose my touch with you guys. Now, would I say that the Power Colors R9290 graphics card is not compatible with the desktop then? Because that's, like, I have OBS, I have DeepBot, I have, you know, SubAlert, I have, I have these programs for a reason. And everybody's like, oh yeah, this is not a big deal. Don't drop a flipping grand on your CPU. It's not worth it. Yeah, I know. And I'm not, like, that's what I mean. Is like, I'm not about to drop a grand on it. Hell no. What I'm saying is, if the price value goes down for those i7 like 5820s, I believe that's what they are, or 5980s, something crazy, basically I'm ready to throw down if the price drops. Like, you need fast RAM, add 32 gigs of RAM. 32 gigs of 2133 DDR4 RAM. And a fast hard drive. I'm getting a solid state hard drive. I'm getting a solid state drive in the next PC build. And I'm getting a better hard drive. I'm getting a bigger hard drive. Like, I plan on getting a couple 4 terabyte drives. So no matter what, I can record the streams and start video editing like a true champ. So that way I can make sweet commercials and little like outro and intros for you guys. Because I'm all about having some fun and goofing around and learning something new. I got friends who are big in YouTube who are like, hey, we'll make you commercials. It's like, no, I want to do it myself on my computer. And, Deceptive Cobras is freaking awesome in the fact that he's like, hell yeah, let's get you some commercials made. And it's like, well, here, GameKey, give this site a gander. It's really informative. Will do, man. Will do. Uh-oh. Hmm. Also, another tip is to Google shopping when buying parts, because you see a list of sites selling that part in either used or new, and will list the price from lowest to highest, and if they have tax or shipping. Yeah, that's what's really cool about it, is I use logical increments to check out all of my parts' current prices and go from there. See, you have a Master White Mage among you. Here, you should have this insignia. Obtained White Mage card. In addition, I will give you this to you in praise of your achievements. Obtained Angel Robe. Hell yeah. I will now continue my travels seeking new metals to temper and all that. Maybe we'll meet again somewhere. That's fine. Well, crap. What was it? The Freelancer I'm working on? Yeah, Freelancer for the Celestial Gloves. Let's see. Devout, Black Belt, Onionites. Yeah, try to click the Tom's Hardware. Yeah, that's what I did. I'm there. I have the i7-4790. Premium gaming, overclocking, and application performance. Yeah, the 5820. Whoa. Hold on. Oh, it's the 5960. That's what it is. The 5820 is not bad at all. 6-core. And then there's the 5930, which is 6 cores with hyper-threading, which is slightly better. The 5820 is definitely where I'm looking. The 5960, I'm saying if that one price drops dramatically when I go to buy. Yeah, the Silverstone, that's what it is. The Silverstone. I was looking at a case like that. No big deal. I know how to build a good gaming machine without going bankrupt. Well, I'm a college student. I have the money when I go back to college. I've been building computers for 20 years. I hear you, Xanth. So 93... Six more levels. Okay. Well, go to Tom's Hardware, click the CPU tab, then best CPUs of June 2015, then use the scroll tab to go to the high-end ones. Got it. I hear you, Bear Rippers. That's what I'll do. I'll definitely give it a check out. Because, yeah. I want a high-end CPU, but at the same time, it's like, to what extent? Goblin looks like he's wearing it. Won't be $1,000, I'll tell you what. Oh, yeah, I know. The i7 you mentioned is actually the one I'm getting, and it's the 5280, I believe that's what it is. It's the i7 5820, my bad, 5820. That's the one I'll be getting, because it's an upgrade from what I currently have in the other desktop. And, I'll just be, you know, when I decide to upgrade the big, ridiculous gaming rig, that's when I'll decide part by part what I'll upgrade, because I'll have a case that fits it all, no matter what. My CPU is like 3 years old and it can run games at 1080p, 60 frames a second while streaming. Hell yeah, Xanth. That sounds freaking fantastic, man. Yeah, the i7s are still new. Like, that's the way I look at it. Like, even my laptop has an i7 in it. But it does not have the power, the gigahertz, to support bigger games. Like, there is no speed in this laptop whatsoever, except to run these lower-end games. Yeah. The board I really want with the CPU combo. 5 years old? Holy crap. Let's see, my laptop runs a NVIDIA, what is it, a GTX 735? So that's not too bad for this laptop, but it comes down to that power. Like, I just don't have it in here. So I just research them separately and make a list of parts you really want. It helps a lot. I did make a complete build of parts that I really want. And then I went ridiculous build. I actually made a build of absolutely the highest end parts with the ridiculous extra hard drives and like two graphics cards in it, just because I was like, that's $7,000 in parts. But I can do that literally over the course of a period of time and just buy part by part if I really, really wanted that kind of craziness. I have an i7-3930K. Bought it November 2012, I guess. Oh, nice. Basically, I'm going to go for a couple of bigger internal hard drives. And then I'm gonna buy an SSD. Bear Rippers, the wattage, it's a 1000 watt Corsair Gold certified on Newegg. So that didn't shut me down. My CPU is an i7-4790. The graphics card is a AMD R9-290. Yeah, it's a 1000 watt. Basically, it's not, it died. It's just like when I go to turn it on, I'm constantly having screen flickering and black screen crashes. Like the whole desktop will just crash and my monitors will black screen and the tower will stay on. So I'm believing, I came down to the conclusion after all of this testing that it's symptoms, it literally is symptoms of the hard drive dying and then the motherboard having issues too. Because if all of the other parts are benchmarking and still firing good and having good quality, then I can come down to pins not being settled in place or the hard drive. That's a graphics error. It's your GPU. That's crap. At this point, I think there's something wonky on the motherboard of that thing. Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, I tried all three PCIe slots. And the motherboard is literally just like, it's crapping out. And that's very annoying. And that's what I told iBuyPower, like, you guys need to check out the motherboard and the hard drives. Like, I need those replaced. Because something is wrong. Strange. Well, shit. I know. And that's what's really bugging me. It's like, I should have been playing on this months ago. I should have still been playing this year on my hard drive since December 18th. I should have been on that hard drive or that computer since. Bear Rippers, the thing is I have a warranty through iBuyPower for 2 more years. Anything happens to the parts, they are slated to change it out at no cost to me. Which is an amazing thing, because I can't afford to buy more parts. You know, I dropped $2,200 on it when I first bought it, and I'm still having issues. It's been 10 months later, and that's where it's like, I really need to be careful, because this is the first summer I decided not to work. And you guys are amazing for even being here. I would say iBuyPower is not exactly screwing me. It's just that I'm stuck in my contract, my warranty with them. Like, it's either I go through my warranty or I have $2,200 that's a paperweight that can't be tested anymore because everything's been told. I've been told through technicians that everything runs fine. I did tell them to fix it, and I addressed my concerns with several supervisors and managers of the customer service group, and I stressed my concerns with the technicians, and it seems like nobody really cares that I spent $2,200 on a rig. They're just like, well, you know, you can sell your computer parts and get your money back. It's like, no, that's the last thing I want to do. I have a friend who bought from them and his is great. I know, that's why I bought from them. That's why I bought from iBuyPower. As I was told, they were amazing. And I saw other streamers using stuff from them and being told that they're amazing. I actually wrote a review on Yelp, and a lot of folks are actually having similar issues. Like, I'm looking right now at Yelp. Yep, no one had concerned to check the parts list at all. Jeez. What is I by Power thinking for some of these folks? Wow, I'm actually reading some of these reviews. This is crazy. Are they just straight refusing to take the PC back to look at it, or what? That's what it sounds like to me. No, they have it. They're accepting it, and it's just like, you know, I don't know what the technician. I personally don't know what the technicians do, but the other company I went to, because this is what the manager said, you felt another company was more credible than we are. That and you went to them for services. So it sounds like you don't have any credibility with us.
Yeah.
And that you don't think we can build computers. That's what the customer service manager said to me. And basically it's this. I didn't trust the fact that I've sent it to them several times and I've had the same issue. I went to another company, my buddy who owns it, lives, you know, his shop is like 45 minutes away from where I live. And, you know, charged me $45 to completely run every single check he could. He opened it up and found that a cable wasn't plugged into my graphics card that should have been. They had a splitter running on my graphics card, a one cable split on my graphics card from the power supply. The other one was wrapped up amongst all the other cables inside the case. There's a 24-pin plugged into the power supply unit, and the clip that keeps it snug is broken off, so now it's not snug anymore. And there were loose screws all over the motherboard. He said the whole motherboard needed all the screws tightened down. And I'm like, are you kidding me? He was like, yeah, just think about it. There are ground screws in your motherboard, so electricity could have been firing to other spots on the motherboard, causing you these issues. We don't know yet. And then after he did all his checks, he started running benchmark programs and tests, and like, he was like, I can't get the same crash that you're having. Oh my god, this is a horror story. Yeah, and, you know, his name's Joe Dunko. That's the guy who checked out my computer personally and found all this stuff. He was like, yeah, I've been doing my computer repair company for, you know, a few years on my own. If you guys don't know what hackathons are, check out Hackathon YSU. That's Youngstown State University. He's basically the host, running all of the advertising for it. Really good guy, good friend of mine, and I trust him. Yeah, it could have shorted something. That's not my fault either, you know. But you're in like I'm in a warranty where basically I Buy Power was like, you basically, you know, signed an electronic agreement on our product. You know, you said okay. And that's where I'm just like, damn it. Two more fights, guys. Two more fights, and a scholar is level 99 in its job class. Yeah, basically, I'll be letting you guys know as I get my desktop back and stuff from iBuyPower, how things are going, what's being done, and how things are being addressed, because this is 10 months of the same problem, screen tearing and black screen crashes, and I don't know what's causing it. I really don't. However, guys, feel free. There's Fry's, there's Magic Micro, there's New Egg, there's, you know, PC part pickers, you know, Amazon and eBay. Like, you can buy parts pretty much from anywhere. I can't recommend iBuyPower. I'm not saying I don't recommend them, but I can't recommend them. And I can tell you my story and why. And, you know, you guys can, you know, take it with a grain of salt and, you know, see how you feel about the company. However, everyone else has had amazing times with them. And this is what I don't get. Like, you know, I can, bitch, grope, moan, and complain all I want, and that doesn't get me a PC any faster. It does not. Like, if I had all 1,480-something of you guys literally, like, hey, you know, tweeting at iBuyPower to fix my PC and being nice about it, you know, courteous, just saying, hey, you know, we really want to see his streams and that we really need you guys to fix the PC, and all of you guys were basically, like, blowing up iBuyPower, then that would be, like, a situation where they might consider it and, like, make sure this computer works to the best of their ability. You know, that's, and this is because I'm not a Twitch partner. I'm not partnered on Twitch. This is why I'm having these problems. You know, someone who is partnered on Twitch can basically be like, hey, you know, I'm partnered on Twitch and I have partnerships with these companies. Hey, you know, this many people, you know, hundreds of thousands of people view me every day, and your computer crashed in front of like 250,000 people. That's kind of a big deal. I was like, oh, 1,500, and he laughed at me and said, sorry for your loss. You know, and that's what I got. I was like, you kidding me? Like, the manager of the customer service department at iBuyPower is just like, what do you want us to do? I'm not a technician. Don't talk to me like I'm a technician. I was like, Arm did that with 1,500 viewers, and they sent a technician that day and got the problem fixed next day with Verizon and their ISP. Yeah, but I'm not Elohim. I'm not a big name on the internet, guys. Bear Rippers, like, it's crazy. You know, people just laugh at me. They're like, whatever. And that's the terrible part. Is that when Elohim had his, had been DDoSed? Bear Rippers? You know, if I were bigger, people wouldn't mind helping me. But because I'm tiny, and I'm not partnered, like, even Bloodcrow is having problems with things, and they refuse to help him. And he's almost three times the size of our channel. You know, Bloodcrow's been putting the time in like crazy every day. And I feel like personally I'm not getting anybody new. You know, ones and twos. We know, but we care. I'll definitely be tweeting them, and yeah, when he was going through the DDoS attacks. Yeah. I remember that. He was like, oh my god, I'm a real streamer. You know, that's what I told my friend Deceptive Cobra. You know, he was like, I've been DDoSed. I was like, dude, well, guess what? You're a real streamer. You're real. You know, people cared enough to DDoS you. That's kind of a big deal. You know, that's crazy. Yeah, all right. Time to go get that scholar her weapons. And I know you guys care. You guys who are here every day, that's the cool part. You guys do care. The fact that, it's not that I'm complaining for not growing, it's just that I've had so many problems is why I feel that we're not growing. And people are like, ew, you're on a laptop? That's gross. Unfollow. And like, I noticed on Twitter, unfollowing is a thing. And I was like, what? Why is this a thing? I see you've mastered scholar among you. Here, you should have this insignia. Obtained scholar card. In addition, I will give this to you in praise of your achievements. Obtained omnitome. I will now continue my travels, seeking new metals to temper and all that. Maybe we'll meet again somewhere. Sweet. It's frustrating. I get you, man. Yeah, it is frustrating, Xanth. And that's why I'm like, holy fuck. Like, you know, the support Deceptive Cobra gave me just 2 days ago, and the news of like, hey, we're going to be talking on Pixel Podcast with the problems you're having, and two subjects of, you know, and like telling me, you know, what's going to be going on and what's going on with him. I was amazed, guys. Like, I was taken aback. I didn't expect him. I didn't expect him to be getting partnered, you know, right away. And two, I definitely did not expect him to be like, hey, I'm going to be putting in a referral with your name on it for Twitch. Like, you're someone I'm looking at to get partnered. And I'm like, wait, what? Like, it scared me and excited me at the same time. Like, I'm on a laptop, and someone wants to try to get me partnered. I'm worried that this isn't good. I'm extremely, you don't understand, extremely worried that this, a laptop stream, is not good enough. Best tip from Elohim I can give you is to look at the top games and top streamers of those games and stay away from them, because then you're just competing with the big names. I would try to join someone's stream team if you can. I know Burke would love to see you in the coalition. Yeah, I know. A lot of you guys, like, I love watching Bruised Lee, and Bruised Lee 01 is a big fan, you know, because I support his streams like crazy, and he is supporting mine like crazy. And then Burke Black is an amazing streamer himself. He's part of the reason why I started streaming. He is part of the reason why. Between him, Tangent Gaming, and Co. Carnage, like, their communities, I sat and watched them for 3 months, and every day for 3 months, for about 2 to 3 hours a piece. And their communities are so interactive with each other, like, on and off stream, that I was like, oh my god, I want my Twitch community to be like that. I want people to help each other out, to work together. You know, I want to be able to, like, get to a point where I can be like, hey, mods, you know, are we making highlights? Is this going on? Is YouTube going well? That kind of stuff. Because I don't have time to do video editing. I don't have time to make highlights all the time. I don't have time for a lot of things. Especially when college kicks off. And, like, you guys have been here through and through. And I'm just, like, that excited about everything. Because you guys keep on giving. When you technically, you don't need to. And it just makes me feel that much more amazing. Oh, the Aegis Shield protects against all status ailments. Okay, got it. Let's get our team set up. I think I can do this now. Let's see. We have someone who's a devout. It's currently going to be our... J-Dog's going to be our black belt. Okay. Fine. Arcade, you'll be our devout. See, I want to stream consoles and portables more than PC. Yeah, I know what you mean, man. I know what you mean. You got the personality and you interact with viewers. You're just missing the numbers. The only way to get them is first with the games. Play interesting games and keep at it. But don't forget to diversify your game library, but mostly have fun. Yeah, and that's what I'm trying to do. I'm having fun with these games, definitely. Let's see, is the warrior in... Oh, the warrior gives that freaking sweet weapon, doesn't he? Yep, he gets the plus 20 to strength and a giant axe that's 155 attack power. Then once you get a small audience from the games, the people will stay for you. I mean, I was pushing it with World of Warships. It was amazing. I was keeping a great audience. And then our desktop went down back in March, if you guys remember that. I believe you guys were all here for that. And then this is the second time I get it back, you know, in April, and then I have to send it right back out. Just need that capture card and webcam. Dude, Xanth, I hope you get it, man. I'll come back and I'll come over and watch the streams, man. Let's take this red mage. We need you to be the... Ah, crap. You're not really much of anything. Oh, yeah? Hey, Xanth. Let's see. I'm just going to run 2 Onion Knights. Fuck it. Screw it. J-Dog is going to be our black belt. Arcade is our devout. And then Weirdo will be the warrior currently for the time being. But we can make him the knight. What's the knight give? Save the queen. Cast reflect when used as an item. Plus 10 to mind, plus 10 to vitality. Ooh. Should I just run, like, 2 Onion Knights? You think? Only character level 99. Okay. I'll be working on that. That's what I'm going to do now. Go here. Rest, yes. Sweet. I slept like a log. Of course you did. Really? Ah, that's right. Weirdo has, like, no freaking magic class whatsoever. His summoner. But I don't have any, like, white mage or black mage abilities. Damn it! And then you don't get any. Alright. I think another day and a half and I'll be completely ready to blast through the game. Here we go. We come back and down and around. Here, run up through all of this, jump the gate. And here we go. Again. You still play World of Warships on laptops, by the way? The one you're on beats the hell out of mine. At 3 GB RAM and integrated graphics, so it should run for you smoothly. Maybe not on ultra graphics, but you could probably still play it. Yeah, I haven't played it in a little while, so I might be able to get into World of Warships tomorrow. However, I am still grinding for the end game of this. But yeah, I am playing World of Warships. I'm testing that out soon because it took me like 3 hours to update and install everything so far. And then tonight when I get offline, I'll be letting it continue to install because I never finished whatever the last installation was that I was on. I don't know how many updates we've had. So I've been like letting it run through that process. It's friggin' crazy. Wait. Oh yeah, that takes a long time because it has to check the files. If you stop or pause it, the whole thing took me about 9 hours from start to finish yesterday. Oh my god, wow. Yeah, I'll be setting that back up when I go back to sleep then. Fuck that. Wow. Excuse my language, but Jesus. Mine took like 30 minutes. I truly weep for your internet. I have 100 down. That's the thing. On my laptop, it's actually my potato PC and potato AIM with AT&T internet. Whoa. Your computer runs better than mine. I think we need to switch services, bro. Let's see, need another little six spot. I'm a spud farmer. I'm surrounded by potatoes. That's funny. I see, I do love my internet connection. Yeah, I love my internet. 100 down and 5 up, guys. 100 megabytes down and 5 up for $100. Look at how big that sword is. That's ridiculous. $100 down, 10 up, $70. Yeah, my area sucks. I'll never have nothing better than 5 up. I would kill for your everything. Flex is so leap. I know, right? Just insane, man. Insane in the membrane. We're lucky here in that regard. Yeah, I know. In my area, if we ever got Google Fiber, they'd be like, oh, $200 a month for what you get then. $200 a month. That's what I feel like. No Comcast, no Time Warner. Yeah, I got fucking Time Warner, and I got AT&T. It's like, I either go with AT&T for nothing, or I go Time Warner, and I get, you know, download speed. Like, I really wish I could work a deal out with them. A deal. It would be freaking amazing. It'd be awesome. You know? Hell, freaking! Our cable company is laying fiber. Wow. I might need to move states. AT&T in my area will give me something like 25 down, zero up for like $50 a month. And I'm just like, no. And they advertise like that's the greatest thing ever. Yeah, preemptive strike. There we go. Now the super linear path here, right now. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I feel like. I completely agree on that, Bear Rippers. Everything's going through DLC. Hey, this game never got completed, but guess what? Pay an additional $50 or $100 and you get the other half of the game when you already paid $60 for the game. Don't worry, the DLCs that don't work also cost $20 a piece, and you can't get the whole game without buying those DLCs too. Like, oh my god, I will rage quit a game for some broken DLC. Rage quit. Because, you know, Final Fantasy 13 did that crap when they were like, oh yeah, the whole game's not out yet, you know, you gotta actually buy the DLC to get the, you know, all the extra content.